shoe. It takes for a while, but it can be trained. What a wonderful use of the language.
It's lovely to have you here, Robin.
It's nice to be here, sir. Took a while, but nice to be here.
Well...
Sammy move.
I thought, as Mrs. Doubtfire might, you know, subtly materialise...
tea, dear.
I'd put a little tea there. If you fancy that, just go for it.
Oh, it's I love that, dear. That's lovely. A little tea and Prozac makes a day go so quick. And some sugar. Ooh, Betty Ford speedball. Great, OK.
You're going to be mum?
Oh, let me be mum. And you dress up. Look at these pants. It's so much easier to do the cuffs. Just a little bit. Show it. Do you like it hot?
Yes.
I bet you do.
Oh, I do.
And do you have a tea ball?
No, but the milk goes in first.
Does it?
Yes, Mrs. I'm
American. What do you want from me?
Well, we won't bother this. I have a little bourbon. You have a little water. The tea's there, everyone.
A little bourbon and water. All of a sudden, we went from Mrs. Doubtfire to Mrs. Doubtfizz.
Baby, a little cocktail.
Cheers.
Here's to you, sweetheart.
Here's to the movie.
Here's to making English a second language.
Okay, thank you.
People drink bourbon after about two or three drinks. They're going, I love you, but I'll kill you.
Yeah, beautiful, baby. I swear to God, let's wake up in a field.
Now, I would like to say, genuinely, I've seen the movie, and it's great family entertainment. It's nice that you're making films for kids, and I can take my little girl along to that. You spent, for the benefit of anyone who does not know, Mrs. Doubtfire, Robert is Mrs. Doubtfire.
He's a woman, yes.
He's a woman? Yeah. I mean, you went the whole way. You did the shaving of arms, and,
yeah.
And did you have leg wax and things like
oh,
that?
Oh, no, I didn't, yeah. And bikini wax, too, which is totally unnecessary, but...
Now we can go to Cannes.
I went to the gynecologist. I thought, this is too much.
Just doing the whole method thing, I even had a period. But no.
Is that too much?
Do you mind? Yeah. Can we have a little jam session?
Right.
Just bits and pieces?
Yeah. It's a lovely guitar.
This is the one that Pras Michael did recently, Ghetto Superstar, which is Ireland.
Yeah, it's been on the charts.
That's right. It's a big record.
Okay.
It's good a bit.
Just go for it.
Islands in the stream, that is what we are. No one in between, how can we be wrong? Sail away with me to another world when we rely. From one lover to another.
Look, I just love this.
All right.
Chop some more.
To be guilty.
And don't
this is fun. Hang on.
This is the one we did for Barbara Streisand.
Yeah.
Pumps and shrinks and darling. How grand we are. Little by little we meet in the middle. There's danger in the dark. It ought to be illegal. Make it a crime to be out in the cold. It ought to be illegal. You got a reason to live in bed alone. With the love you're living on, you gotta be mine. We take it away. It's gotta be nine and eight, a matter of time. And we got nothing to be guilty of. Our love will climb any mountain, near or far. We are, and we never let it end. And we got nothing to be sorry for. Our love is one in a million eyes can see. That we got a highway to the sky. Don't wanna hear goodbye. Don't wanna hear goodbye.
Incidentally, how was Miss Streisand in passing? Was she good, easy to get along with?
She was a pleasure. Yeah. It was a 6-month project,
and she really learnt the songs, and she's a true professional, obviously. But she's had some people have said she's very tough, but I think in a business that's male dominated, and there's nothing better.
To be male dominated, when I think about it.
But it's very difficult for a woman to sort of to thrust herself forward, which is also very good. Thank you.
What a thrusting.
So yes.
So you put the two of those things together and you have quite a night.
Yes.
Dominating thrustfully.
Yes, dominating thrust. It's all on video.
It's all on video.
Right, well, before you're getting any deeper there.
Sorry,
yeah. Do you have any more you could I could sit here all night and hear these. We want some more, don't we? Any more?
All right, one more.
Are we going to do my one? Are we going to do the one that I've recorded, one of your songs?
Oh, well, you want to do Let's Pretend?
No, not I Pretend. I've recorded How Deep Is Your Thingy?
Oh, you want?
Do it, yes.
Yeah. I want to be in the right key. Yeah.
Do you?
It doesn't matter with me. Any key, trot on out.
Okay. Okay, take your chance on the key, all right?
Yeah, all right.
No, this is a cappella.
Is it?
You've been there?
No, it's a lovely
it's
place.
It's lovely, yeah.
It's in Mexico, isn't it?
Yeah, my name is. Yeah.
Yes, it is, actually.
Oh, that's Acapulco.
Yeah, it's all right.
Go on, you start. I'll jump on.
All right, calm down, calm down.
Are we getting paid for this?
No.
I was just wondering that myself. Go on.
I know your eyes in the morning sun. I feel you touch me in the pouring rain. And the moment that you wander far from me, I wanna feel you in my arms again. And you come to me on a summer breeze, keep me warm in your love, then you softly leave. And it's me you need to show. How deep is your love?
How deep is your love? How deep is your love? I really mean to learn, 'cause we're living in a world of fools, breaking us down when they all should let us be. We belong to you and me.
Yeah. Thank you, fellas.
Thank you, Dave.
Larry, you're not the first person to
see you. Looks different on the telly, doesn't it? Yeah, you go around the other way.
It does look different on the telly. You wouldn't be the first to get. Mel Gibson, 2 years ago, did a tour before he arrived here.
Yeah.
I like the Barney. It's.
Yeah, everyone keeps going on about my hair. Yeah.
Well, I read about you being a blonde.
Yeah, well, I was blonde for the film. Good link, Des.
Yes. Well, we'll talk about the film in a minute. Right. Let's talk about you for a second. By the way, is it more fun being blonde?
It is, yeah, but I can't talk about it on the telly, Des.
Go on, be a devil.
Well, I got my hair dyed blonde, went straight home, and my wife Barbara... no, I can't.
Did she like it? Did it appeal?
Yeah, I mean,
it's
fetching. Actually.
It's very fetching.
I keep walking around London and looking at myself on the posters for Mavis Davis, my new film. Yeah. And,
we've got that message.
I look at the posters and I say, oh, who's that guy? And you look in the mirror and there's this sad old act. Because I did The Bill and I had to have my hair dyed crap for The Bill. And, it just makes me look sad, really.
You've done loads of TV. I mean, you've done as much television as most around. You've done. I don't want to make you sound like old Father Time.
Yeah, but it's funny, Des, because you still get really nervous about chat shows. You know, when you.
But you don't seem nervous at the moment.
Well, good. Good actor, you see. No, but it's the majority of my work is scripted sitcom. Yeah. Multicam, heavily rehearsed stuff, and then they say, you're going on to meet Des, and we don't meet, you know, we haven't met
yet. It's funny, we have never met.
No.
It's very nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you too, Des.
We have never met, and that's the truth, all these years in the business, we're not met. So we'll put that right.
Can I ask you something, because we haven't met, and I've always wanted to know why Eric Morecambe did all that stuff about you. Were you all, I mean, have you been asked that a million times?
We were good mates, and then one day I told him I wanted to be a singer, and he said, well, I'd like to have an affair with Brigitte Bardot, Des. But... He said, all things are not possible, boy. So I said, I'm gonna be a singer. He said, I should join the Royal Ballet. And it never stopped from then, Rick. It just went on and on. This private joke became a national... Somebody put it in the paper, and then every comic, every Cobb report in the land was doing. Get back to
you. But you never got sick of it. You never got sick of it.
I mean, I did get sick of it. One day at the Palladium at the stage door, a little old lady came up to me, and I'd done quite a good show that night. She said, "Oh," she said, "come here," and she pulled me close, and she said, "Will you send me your new LP? There's a fiver." So I said, and in those days they didn't cost a fiver. I'm talking about a long time ago. I said, "Well, you can get it in the shops for $3.99." She said, "I'm not going to go in and ask for it."